Foster the People is an American indie pop band that was formed in 2009 by lead singer Mark Foster, with drummer Mark Pontius, lead guitarist Sean Simone, and keyboardist Isan Amis. The band started when Mark Foster moved his life from Cleveland, Ohio, down to Los Angeles to pursue his musical dreams due to his father's support and encouragement. Once in LA, Foster struggled to find fame on his own, finding work through various jobs by making jingles for commercials and attending social events to expand his connections. Through this, he landed an opportunity with Aftermath Entertainment that eventually fell through, which finally led Foster into forming a band of his own. He reached out to Cubby Fink, an old friend who had recently lost a job in television production, and Mark Pontius, a film student who dropped out to help form the band with Foster. The original name of their group was Foster and the People, but would always get announced or misheard as Foster the People instead, so they eventually changed the name to show the image of the band as Taking Care of People. In 2010, shortly after the group had been formed, Mark Foster wrote the song Pumped Up Kicks, which would eventually be the breakthrough song for the band and their first official single as a band. They eventually got in contact with managers and several record deals trying to get them to sign with them before they eventually signed with Startime International for a multi-album deal. Pumped Up Kicks quickly grew in popularity, reaching the Billboard music charts for both rock and alternative music in January of 2011. In an interview with NME in 2014, Mark Foster talks about how the song came to be and transformed into a song about a school shooting and about the song's surge to popularity.
I think, you know, in terms of the lyrical content, you know, I wrote the chorus first. And it was kind of an interesting defining moment for that song, actually, because the chorus, without the verses give a different context to the chorus. The chorus by itself, before the verses were written, was really, it was really kind of a confidence song. All the other kids better run from my gun, but gun, at that point, was just a metaphor. It wasn't a literal thing. The whole first verse was just a freestyle. The recording and the lyric, it just kind of came out at once. And that's when I kind of knew that the song was actually about a kid. And that it was actually that gun in the chorus was actually a literal thing. Because when the song started to break, just on blogs, and it started to catch some real traction, I remember just walking into rehearsal with my band with my hands on my head, just saying, I can't believe that this is the first song that people are going to hear from us.
In May of 2011, the band released their first full-length album, Torches, which debuted at number 8 on the Billboard Top 200. Pumped Up Kicks continued to grow, landing at the number 1 spot on alternative charts and number 3 on rock charts in June of that same year, and peaked at number 3 on the Hot 100, spending 8 consecutive weeks in that position over the summer. In 2012, Torches was nominated for Best Rock Album of the Year. Foster the People were nominated for Top New Artist, Rock Artist of the Year, and Alternative Artist of the Year. And Pumped Up Kicks won Best Rock Song of the Year at the Billboard Music Awards. On March 18th, 2014, Foster the People released its second album, Supermodel, with their newest hit single, Coming of Age, that was released earlier that year in January. In a 2017 interview with Live in Limbo, Mark Foster talks about the inspiration behind the album.
Yeah, and with Supermodel, it was interesting because that record, I felt like we were pretty comfortable and apathetic almost.
Yeah.
Towards how other people were living, especially like in the U.S. and living in, mm-hmm. I mean, like, we live inside of a bubble, you know, because we're in Los Angeles inside of the U.S.,
yeah.
Which you've got like a big bubble of the U.S. and then this other bubble that's like L.A. And so, you know, I think with Supermodel, it was more outspoken and I guess more direct and like a little bit more like volatile and like acidic, you know, kind of talking like directly to those things and those issues and almost wanting to kind of slap people around a bit, being like, hey, like,
yeah,
maybe you should like wake up a bit and like look around and see that, you know, see what's really going on, see where things are headed. And
feels like it's coming. To help promote the album, the band hired the artist Young and Sick, who did both the cover art for Supermodel and Torches, to paint a mural in downtown Los Angeles. The mural took 10 days and the time lapse was released as the music video for the song Coming of Age, and the band held a free concert on January 24th to commemorate the mural. Unfortunately, since then, the mural has been painted over due to legal reasons. However, upon the album's release, it began to grow as a message of capitalism behind the album that caught the eye of the media. In an interview in 2014 with BBC Breakfast, the band was asked about whether they would consider themselves a political band.
Here it is. Do you consider yourselves to be a political group as such band?
No, I wouldn't say we're a political group. I think it's, you know, something that we all think about. It's something that we're engrossed in our culture, but I don't think we're necessarily a political band.
On September 23, 2015, Foster the People announced that lead bassist and founding member Cummy Fink was leaving the group to pursue other opportunities. He left the band with good relationship with all the members and stated that it was a true gift getting to perform for such loyal, passionate, and heartfelt people. I will miss playing and seeing you all on the road. God bless you all. Shortly after his departure, the band added guitarist Sean Simone and keyboardist Asan Amiss. With the two new members, Foster the People released their newest album, Sacred Hearts Club, on June 13, 2017. In an interview with Live in Limbo in 2017, the group talks about what inspired them and their new album.
So obviously a lot has changed in the world since 2014. Not to get too political here, but how has the outside influences influenced the album and how you kind of, what came out of it?
I mean, I think it influenced it a lot, actually, because pretty much when we first started working on this record was when things started to really kind of go sour, I feel like, globally.
Yeah.
You know, the Syria crisis with ISIS and everything started to get really bad, and that started to affect Europe and started to, you know, the political race in our country with Trump and Hillary and the leaks and just like a lot of turmoil. And so I think going into the record, you know, it was important for us to, I mean, I think, you know, I mean, as artists, like, to respond to what's happening in the world, for sure. But I think for us, it was to do something counter to the spirit of what was going on and try to make something joyful.
Yeah.
You know, I think really kind of like looking at just how divided people were getting and being conscious that music is one of the most unifying things and wanting to make something that, you know, could really bring people together despite their differences.
They named the album Sacred Hearts Club as a reference to all those who didn't fit in the world and as a way to bring people together, and just as their name states, to foster people and bring everyone together as one. Next time I just won't come.